Let's let them know who really got it. Came up from the bottom, now we riding in a Mozzie. And these margellas done burnt a hole in my pocket. See me, I'm shining.
Yo, what's going on, guys? It is your boy Bugs, and today, guys, we're going to be continuing our tier list. If you don't know, I previously dropped a video called the Multiversus Nair tier list, which was all about, you know, air down attacks. Now we're going to be moving on to the Nair tier list. That is your neutral air attacks. Let's get straight into this video. Now, actually, before we jump into the video, let me explain the rules and why these moves are where they're going to be placed into this video. They are based off of their property, priority, how good they are, combo-wise, what they lead into, what they can do, etc. And let's get straight into the video. Now, the number one Nair move in this game, I don't care what anyone says, you can't change my mind on this, is Finn's Kick. Finn's Kick is everything. This move, so you know how when you're in disadvantage, you're supposed to just, you know, try to dodge, jump, you know, use things to get away from your opponents. Yeah, not this kid. Yeah, he just pushes one button, kicks you, takes you up with him, up attack you, and then up specials you, kills you in book bag, dunzo, you're dead. Like, this move doesn't have crazy it still has good priority, but it's just, I'm sorry, I just watch clips, bro. Just see these clips. Like, it's just not fair. It's just not fair. Forget everything else. The fact that you can reversal everybody with this one move like nothing, like it's his bread and butter, is crazy. That's why it's number one. We're gonna move on. You don't need no more explaining. Number two is Steven's Nair. Yes, Steven Nair is so slept on. Shoot, I've been playing this game for months, and I didn't learn about this until I think 4 months into the game. Steven Nair gives armor, and the longer you charge it, the longer the armor is. So he literally has a move that gives armor off that doesn't take away his dodge meter, like how when Wonder Woman does the downward blast, it takes away her dodge meter. But she does have other moves that are that does it, but gives shield for like a minimal time. He literally is able to charge it to fully give his teammate armor that could last quite some time to go in to attack. And also, fully charged Nair does 15 damage. It also has combo game, good priority. This move is very slept on. And on characters like, I want to say, what is it, IG? Yeah, IG. You can literally just walk in. Oh, good momentum too. You can literally just fly in with the bubble with IG as he walks in. Blast him, he gets armor, now he can do whatever he wants. This move is just brutal. Up next we have is Shaggy's Nair. Yes, this move, to be honest, there's a whole bunch of stuff I could say about it, combo wise and all that stuff. It is the number one priority move in the game. Like, I swear to God, if a Shaggy's above your head, not only that he has his Nair, he has Nair. Nair beats everything from underneath and to next to him. Why to next to him? I don't know. I guess it's because of how his feet are moving. But my God, when I say that there is not one move that this can't outreach this move, there is not one move, I think. Maybe stretchy. Maybe stretchy punch could do it. Maybe. But even then, this move is just, the combo game. He could carry you off the stage with it, and it doesn't count for a neutral, so all he's doing is wasting his jumps for it. It's just, oh my God, this move is brutal. All right, up next we have is Jake Nair. This move, it definitely toned down a little bit and definitely isn't as brutal as it was, especially that you were able to do a beautiful, nice recoveries with it by just staying in the air forever with your Nair and up attack. It definitely nerfed the air time of it, but it's still a very strong priority move. Like, even like from the backside of it, like if he's not aiming at you, as long as you touch around him, it literally will suck you in and throw you the way that he's aiming at. So for example, if he's doing a backward Nair going to the blast zone and you mess up your punch or whatever trying to punish him, and you touch him with it, like a punch or whatever, and you miss and he gets you, you're literally getting sent straight off the map. Like, this move priority is right up next to Shaggy's lane, and it is actually brutal, and is also good comboing into skateboard on big characters and decent sized characters. And again, just priority in general for neutral game. Again, it is a neutral button, but yeah, it move kind of something. Next we have is Velma Words. Yes, of course I'm gonna put Velma Words into the god tier. Like, this is literally a tracking move, and it's just good protection when you're getting off stage and throwing off stage. You just throw words and, you know, it just protects you and stuff. And then again, like I said, it has tracking. Literally, you can ladder people upwards if they waste all their dodges and stuff. Also, if it goes to your teammate, actually it doesn't heal you anymore, but it does get bigger and, you know, It's just a bigger projectile flying at your enemies or protecting your teammates, circling around them, you know? So, pretty good. And you can circle an area if you want to. You can literally aim this to a certain place and start throwing words, and it will literally circle around this one area on the map for a decent amount of time. So, yeah. This move is definitely up there. Next, we have, oh, yes, your Lord and Savior, Batman. This man's neutral Batarang literally is just brutal. One, it you know, he throws it, and guess what? It's a boomerang, so it comes back to him. And a lot of people don't know this, but if he dodges his own Batarang, it will go and come back and go and come back, and guess what? He could just jump around. He could physically just jump over and over and make a circle him as protection, and then whenever he really wants to take it back, he could get it. And by the time he, you know, gets his Batarang back, he could throw it again if he really wanted to. Not only that, he has a perk that he could throw it, and if it hits you from behind, it gives you 3 stack of weakness. Beautiful starting combo. Now, it doesn't extend combos anymore because they actually did nerf up the startup time on the move. But, you know, still good for that. And good protection off stage. You know, for example, some of your enemies get you off stage, throwing a Batarang literally conditions them to back up from you because, you know, it's a flying projectile coming at them. And again, even if they dodge it, guess what? It's coming right back to you. So it's going to hit them if they do that. And they got to dodge that, and it gives you enough time to get back on stage. Pretty brutal move. Now, this move, I didn't really want to put up here, but I already know a lot of people's going to be down my back in thrill if I don't put her up here. But I'm going to have to do it. Is Harley's Nair. Yes, her hammer is big and it hits everywhere, literally. This move has decent combo game, but it's just the priority. It's like the whole Shaggy and Jake thing. It just has so much priority that it just covers everything. And again, even when you dodge through it, guess what? It has a nice little sweet spot in the back. So yes, you can actually use that to her advantage off stage and stuff, which can pretty much kill you at like 60, 70 if you're like off stage, like in the middle, and she hits you with that backside of her Nair. You might be dead depending on how heavy your character is. Move is very, very strong. Alright, up next we have S tier. And guys, the reason why I only have God tier, S tier, and A tier is because really looking at this list, it was very, very hard to actually differentiate where I want to place all these moves. Even some moves can be moved around. Like this list, in all honesty, is not perfect. Except Finn. Finn is perfect where he's at. And Steven. And Shaggy. And Jake. But everybody else, it could vary. It could definitely vary. But up next, we have is Bugs Bunny. Yes, Bugs Bunny's Nair is just so beautiful. One, it still combos off stage beautifully into itself 3 times and finishes up with a nice back kick, or I think a Sarah. I think Sarah's a little bit harder to get, but up bat he could easily get, and he could follow up with a dare if you're trying to fall out of it easily. 2, beautiful combo game on stage, and 3, beautiful priority. It's literally him spinning around with a nice you know, hitbox. The best thing you're doing was go underneath him, and it's very hard to hit him from the top, I'm not gonna lie. Up next we have is Black Adam's Nair. Yes, this clap is death, bro. His hitbox is so brutal. It doesn't really combo into itself or anything, but it's just the priority it has and the knockback that this move has. And like I said, it's not really a true combo into itself, but God, I mean, you could literally charge it as much as you want, so you could literally bait people into dodging and then throwing out the move in the same frame of you charging it. So this move is, it gets the job done. All right, this move is something. Up next we have is Gizmo. I really wanted to put him very higher next to Batman and stuff because I've been preaching this since day one. Little arrow is better version of Batarang. I'm sorry, bro. He literally has an arrow that he could fully charge, right? And then he could dodge away, and he can have a full loaded speed arrow whenever he wants to. Like, the only reason why it's not up there is because it doesn't have a lot of knockback. But it has a nice, decent hit stun, and it literally combos into anything. You literally hit someone with that and combo and do whatever the hell you want. But again, doesn't have crazy damage, doesn't have a crazy knockback, so that is why it's down here. But I think it's still a very, very strong neutral move that you can literally bait people when they're off stage. And then guess what? Popcorn. Yeah, I forgot that I said that. It's not only based off the move, but what else can the move do with his other move, Popcorn? Arrow into Popcorn at nearly at 100 off stage, not off stage, on stage, like the edge of the stage. It's pretty much a kill. And it does a nice, like I said, yeah, knockback. Yes, good kill, great kill, great, amazing kill. And yeah, it's just, you can literally hold the move as long as you want and bait people to waste their options. Like I said, like, you're literally aiming an arrow at them, they're coming at you, they're gonna try to anticipate you to shoot it. You can literally just hold it, because they're not gonna try to attack you. If they try to attack you, you're just gonna shoot the arrow, boom, you win neutral right there. But yeah, that is why it's there. Really want to put it higher, but as of right now, I think this is where it's going to be at. Up next we have is Taz. Yes, this sleeper of a character. Soup is such a beautiful move. My god, one, it has nice priority. Two, it is actually counted as a projectile if you didn't know that. So, it actually could trade off with a lot of characters. Actually, every character, yes. If you're throwing out a punch at Taz while he's souping, don't get me wrong, you're gonna hit him, but guess what? He's also gonna hit you. And guess what that is also gonna do? Add that nice, beautiful passive he has, Tasty. That's gonna be right onto you. Yes, this guy move is beautiful. And it does some nice combo game if you know how to, use it correctly, as you see in the background. Hopefully I'm editing this correctly and you see some nice clips with it. Yeah, I'm gonna make it more interesting than the Dare one. The Dare one kind of boring, you know. It's just a, you know, the tier list, and I was just doing it and saying it. I'm gonna add some clips to make it, you know, prove my point a little bit more. Up next we have is Morty's gun. I actually really had this at the top of S. I low-key wanted to put this in God tier because, again, I feel like this is like Gizmo's neutral button, you know, the arrow, because it just, one, it's so fast, you know. It's pretty much like a charged up arrow as much as you want, but the only thing is it is on a way longer cooldown, and it, again, it just combos into everything. Like, whatever you, as soon as you know, you just be running around, jumping around, as soon as you get next to the opponent or even close, you could just, you know, pop it real quick. They get hit, and then guess what? Free combo for you. And not only that, it's a beautiful edge guarding tool too. You know, you can bait people into, like, when you get them off stage, if you know how to space yourself next to the ledge, you can literally, you know, act like you're gonna go to them. They're gonna waste your stuff, they're gonna go down to the ledge, you get right into position, you shoot it, and it just spikes them pretty easily, and they can spike them upwards if they try to go high. Like, this move is pretty good. Up next we have is Superman's Nair. This move, I would put it in God tier if he didn't get nerfed. Obviously he didn't get nerfed like crazy, but I will say it is a little bit more toned down versus these other Nairs, because like I said, all these Nairs, now looking at them, guys, they are so good, but this is just based on what I feel is a little bit better. And this move is still very strong. It has decent priority, especially off stage. I don't know what is it when a Superman has you off stage. You could dodge, you could jump, you could try to throw out your own move, but for some reason this move just wins. On stage, you know it's 50-50. Off stage, oh, forget it, bro. You just lose, and I just don't get why. But yeah, this move is great for comboing, great for combo off stage, great for gimping, all that stuff, amazing. Up next we have is a Wonder Woman's Nair. Yes, the reason why this one is only right here, like I said, there's just so much better Nairs in my honest opinion, but it is still a high and great top tier Nair in my opinion, because one, it is, I would say, top two best armor breaking move in the game. It has nice fluent momentum, you know. She gets to just throw herself out there and go whap whap whap, and it's a two hitter, and also it's also a combo extender, you know, Nair into Nair, and then guess what, you could jump into your, oh, not Nair, grounded Nair into Nair, and then, you know, you could jump and extend combos, you know, punching people. There's a whole bunch of, it's pretty much a beautiful combo extender, and like I said, just a nice fluent armor breaking move, which is just really good in my honest opinion. Up next we have is Rick's portal, his laser. Yes, his laser has great momentum. It's a beautiful projectile that does decent knockback, and feels like it definitely has that strong stage control. You know, it's not too hard to go against, but again, because of where you're positioned and stuff, this move is very strong, because one, when he throws out that laser, guess what? If you have to dodge it, he can follow up with it. Even if you be smart and try to, you know, go underneath it, guess what? You gotta follow up with him also coming at you. This move could do a lot of stuff, especially with portals. Not only that, it could do passive damage whenever hell it wants to by just shooting it rapidly, really fast. Also, great momentum when floating and stuff, trying to fly back on stage or just to get away from your opponents, or to shoot it when your opponent's reaching, trying to get at you enough time to get it off, you know, and punish them. Move is great. Up next and final in the S tier we have Aria. Yes, Aria, this move isn't too crazy. It is definitely nice priority, which I'm very shocked about. You know, I get, you know, she's like throwing her thing out, but you really expect it to be like more of like an air move. Like, you see people actually use this while going to the ground, and it actually has a lot of priority, which I'm very surprised about. But it's just, you know, still a really strong move. Great combo into, you know, up special Dare into Nair, and a repeatedly, especially on big characters like Superman, Garnet, Wonder Woman, heavy characters, Jay, Shag, you know, stuff like that. Great move. Nothing too crazy like the others. And then finally, we're going to be going down to our quote-unquote low tiers. And like I said, they're not really low tiers. It's just compared to everybody else on this list, they're just at the bottom, sadly. But their Nairs are still, you know, amazing. But on the top of A list we have is Garnett. Yes, do you see this? Do you see this hitbox? Do you see how big this is? Bro, I think they buffed it because I don't even think it's at these 4 points anymore. I think it's even within her on the sides. It's just, I think it's just a box. I honestly think the hitbox is just a box, guys. Like, this move has so much priority. It could spike. It could spike upwards. It just has so much priority. It's beautiful. But unfortunately, it's very noticeable and readable. You know, when you see them do it, guess what? Just walk away. But again, sometimes when you're in certain positions, you're just like, you know what? I could beat that move. Or you know what? I have to fight it, you know, go through and see if I can attack first. And sometimes you just don't, and the move just gets beaten. Up next we have is IG. Yes, I actually put IG decently high and not last place like I usually do in tier lists. But yeah, I think this move is pretty nice, especially into up attack and stuff. And those are nice little gimps that you could get, especially with bolts. So a lot of things IGs love to do is, like, when people try to kill them from the top, they'll pop bolts. And then this move is a great move to gimp. It literally hits them upwards, and again, you just do one little up attack and they're dead. So that is why it's up here. Definitely probably could be higher, but like I said, just based off of everyone else's move and combos and etc. and priority, I just feel like they use their stuff a little bit more than what IG gets out of it. You know, his is more of a punishing move, like how Finn is pretty much. But I just feel like Finn could do it whenever. And then again, forgot to mention, he could combo into whatever the hell he wants to after he kicks you, even sometime without the cooldown. But yeah, let's move on. Next we have is Marvin. Yes, that little bubble he shoots, I low-key want to put this a little bit lower, but I think the bubble is very slept on because it actually has some ridiculous knockback, and that's the only reason why I'll put it above some of these other moves, because these other moves are great. But overall, this move just, it's a sleeper, you know, especially if he's up in the air and he's just shooting out a bubble. Kind of don't want to approach that, because if he hits you with that, or he sets up after getting back on stage into bubble, that might, you know, confirm into your death. Up next we have his rain dog. Neutral attack on the ground is amazing. I think in the air, because they're both the same move, but I think in the air is just a little bit weaker and underused. Same how Marvin is. Again, Marvin I think is the same button, but in the air, I just feel like it's not that, not say not useful, just underused and not really seen as a great move to use when you're in the air. So same thing with Rain Dog, but obviously still a great move. It's literally a projectile that can protect you when people are trying to, you know, take you out when you're off stage and stuff. Still a great move, just very, very slower than others. Up next we have is Stripe. Yes, Stripe Saw Blade. This move is a patrolling move on the stage. You know, it pretty much acts like a hazard. Great air stalling, great baiting, because you could angle it up and down, momentum, you could, you know, air stall with it a decent amount. Great move, nothing too crazy, but definitely good. You could up special into itself, he could do combos with it, which I love doing. You know, I love throwing out a saw blade, hitting the saw blade, and then it hitting them again, and then it's beautiful. But isn't too crazy, but definitely still a strong Nair move. Up next we have is Tom and Jerry. Yes, Tom and Jerry. I think this move could definitely go higher too, but again, it's just so underused, and just there's better things to do than just reflecting a projectile back and forth over and over. Still a great move. Also could use this into hitting rocket and stuff. Like I said, all these Nairs are so great, but I just feel like there are some that are just way better or used more than the move. You know, it's a great move. It's literally a move that could reflect any projectile, except heavies, but any projectiles coming at you, you can literally just racket it and now it's yours, you know. But sadly, I'm gonna put it down here on the near list. And then finally, the worst quote-unquote near in the game is LeBron. Yes, this move isn't bad. Again, it's like armor break, so it's kind of like Wonder Woman's. I feel like Wonder Woman's hitbox is a little bit bigger. His is more like kind of straightforward and kind of doesn't like overlap type stuff, besides, you know, left and right. But again, just there's so much better Nairs in my honest opinion that I would rather use than his. But his is gonna be at the bottom. Still great move. Goes into up attack, great spacing, and again, it's armor break. It's a nice fluent move of armor break, but it's, in my opinion, Wonder Woman has a way better, more fluent version of what he has. But that is it for the Nair tier list, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed it. As always, the link will be in the description so y'all could do your own Nair list and y'all could at me on Twitter, because I love seeing people tier lists on anything and y'all thoughts and y'all opinions and stuff. Leave a like if you like the video, comment about anything. Again, comment those tier lists, I want to see them. And this is your first time ever watching my videos and you do enjoy it, hit the subscribe button, guys, and I'm out, guys. Peace. Yeah, she got a man she don't really give a fuck about, left him back home in a whole other state, moved to LA because she want to be famous, got another 5 on the side, she a waitress, but it's getting tough, hard to find that.